Beautiful Tonight is the first track on our new album, Gravity. It's definitely a bit different for Westlife. It's a lot more up-tempo. The actual song is about it's about a wedding. It's a guy getting married and feeling how special it is to be marrying this girl. But it's a completely different kind of vibe for Westlife, and it's a great start to the first song.
Safe is actually the single, as everybody knows, from the new album Gravity. It's a song written by James Grundler and John Shanks. It's a big ballad, big Westlife ballad. Quite a dramatic song, quite meaningful, tasty lyrics, I would have said. And great song, great video, and then the single.
You're like gravity, even if the wind blows. It makes it hard to...
Video, saw us kind of start our acting career within Westlife. Usually anything we've done in the past, we've usually got vignettes and stuff, and actors do the vignettes. But this time around, we act our own stuff out and run up and down corridors. Mark was in a burning car, Keane saved him. Shane stopped some guy from punching a girl.
Pretty good.
And I won the Oscar from running down the corridors and up the stairs and saving a girl from jumping on the roof. The rest of the boys were nominated, of course, but the Oscar went to me, so I was quite pleased with that. Thanks, Mom.
Chances is a song that was originally recorded and written by a band called Athlete, and the first time we heard the song was when we went to meet Simon Cowell in his office, and he'd done that thing where he gets like this CD from out of his, you know, jacket pocket and goes, "Guys, I want to play you a song. Now just hear it out before you say anything." And he put it in his big speaker system and played it. And I mean, apart from the fact that Athlete's vocal is quite sort of emo and rock and kind of, it's not so pop, which threw us for a second. We did like the song, and the production is really epic, and the lyrics are fantastic as well. So an interesting fact was that Richard Curtis, the movie director, actually suggested the idea to Simon for us. So anyways, we said we'd try it, you know, and I think it's a typical example for Westlife can take a song, and as long as we sing it, our voices make it a Westlife record, you know. The Athlete record is quite rock and emo, and our version is, you know, very pop because we're singing it. So yeah, it's a very dramatic song production-wise. It's got some fantastic orchestral bits in it. But it's number three on the album, which proves that we all like it, and Simon definitely likes it.
Everybody's gonna answer to a question that they need to know. Still broken over.
I Will Reach You is a song that actually Mark wrote, and he played us this song originally kind of around the start of the summertime, and straight away, I mean, we all started jumping up and down about this song because it's got, well, number one, it's up-tempo, and it was probably the first up-tempo that was played to us for the Westlife album this year, and we're always looking for up-tempos. So, and then second of all, it's actually an amazing song. It's like, you know, one of our favourite songs on the album. Obviously, it's up there at number four. It's just a real feel-good song. It's one of them songs that, like, kind of, you know, puts a smile on your face. You can see it in concerts, you know, the lyrics, you know, put your hands in the air, light a candle. It's all kind of real feel-good, kind of like, let's go and, you know, rock it up. I mean, it's a great song. I think it's going to be brilliant on tour. A very possible single as well, I think, for sure. So, well done, Mark.
Hello, Mark.
Track 5 is a song called Closer. It's a song written by John Shanks and John Reid, and actually ourselves, we got involved in the co-writing of this song, which was great. John definitely got us more involved in the creative side of this album, which was fantastic for us. But it's a great song. It was one of the first songs that we've done. It's got a great beat to it. You know, possibly could have been the first single. We felt it was definitely up there as one of the first single choices, but Simon thought Safe was the better song to go with. But it's a great song, and possibly a single, yeah, who knows.
That I just want.
Track 6 is a song called The Reason, and the song itself was a big hit for Who Was Tank in 2004 or 5 or something like that.
In America, wasn't it?
In America, yeah. And I personally love the song. And then it was suggested to us this year for this album. And one of the last songs we cut, to be honest with you, because we kind of felt, well, we didn't think we needed it. You know, we thought we've enough going on with what we're doing with John in the studio, original was.
We were focusing on the original song at that point.
Yeah, and we didn't think that The Reason, you know, needed to be cut right at that point. However, it was going so well. We all liked the song anyway. We thought, you know what, let's give this a bash. Let's see how it sounds. And I think we really surprised ourselves because it's become a favourite on the album for us all. You know, I think it's become a single potential, to be honest. And I think it shows that, you know, they knew what they were talking about when they suggested cutting the record because it's a great song.
Tell Me It's Love is the first song that we recorded for the album, and straight away we got in with John, and you'll hear sort of all the kind of BVs that are all over it, and it was like one of the first things he said was we need to stack up a load of BVs, because we were kind of talking about, you know, vocal arranging and getting involved more in that, and, you know, hearing lush harmonies, you know, and hearing our voices coming through and everything like that. So it was such a great start to start off with that song, because it showed us that John was willing to kind of take us forward, even just with things like backing vocals and stuff. And yeah, it's kind of like a bit of an Elton John song with a bit of a sort of an R&B flow to it as well. It's a fantastic song, and I think it was a very exciting start to our relationship with John. And actually, Mr. Nicholas James Adam
Byrne. Bernard James Adam.
Nicholas Bernard James Adam Byrne.
Mary's.
Actually, does a great vocal in the mid lane as well, which is fantastic.
Yeah, it's his best vocal he's ever done.
I don't know if I'd say that, but I'd go with it.
Track 8 is a song called I Get Weak, and this is a really exciting song in the album because it's got quite a different feel to it. It's got a different groove, a different beat. It kind of starts off a little bit eerie and a little bit dark, and it's got, you know, that kind of Rihanna feel to it almost once the second verse kicks in. But it's definitely one of my favourite songs in the album. I always seem to kind of skip to it really fast and then go back.
That's because you sing on it.
Well, I sing on it as well, but that, I genuinely think it's one of the best songs in the album.
All things come to those who wait. Sometimes they just come too late. And if we never speak again.
Before Too Late was actually a song that was written a while back. We were asked to write a song for the X Factor winners, and we went in and said, well, let's not just do a song about winning the X Factor and winning and This Is My Moment just for the sake of it. Let's just write a good song and, you know, see how it goes. It's actually inspired by the passing away of Nicky's dad and Kian's dad not too long before that. It was very fresh in our minds, and it's about basically, you know, I think if you leave things unsaid, it may be that it will be too late in the end, because, you know, someone can pass away and you'll never get to say certain things to them. So it's kind of urging people to say things right now before it's too late.
And No One's Gonna Sleep is definitely a different sound for Westlife. It's a very exciting sound. It was the first song that John Shanks and actually Wayne Hector, who did a lot of our earlier songs in our earlier part of our career, they got together and they just wanted to do something completely different for Westlife. And they created a kind of a, some might say a dance kind of song. It's a flat out dance song, and it's great. Vocally, it's very enjoyable to sing, but it's got a great anthem feel to it. It's something that we'll definitely do on tour, I'm sure. But all in all, it's a great kind of song. At that point in the album, it really kind of wakes you up and go, okay, not expecting this, but great.
The Difference in Me is a really nice song on this album, actually. It's really chilled out, really relaxed, kind of, you know, really small. It's not one of them songs that's like, you know, big and powerful. It's more like a, it's kind of got a Jack Johnson feel to it, you know, a real summery beach feel to it. And Shane's vocal on it is actually quite different. It's quite low and it's quite husky, I would say, wouldn't you? So it's a very relaxed, very chilled out song. One of them songs that, you know, you can kind of see yourself lying on a beach listening to. But a really nice song, for sure.
Hello, happiness, tell me where you've been. I miss the sound of your voice, I miss the touch of your skin.
Too Hard to Say Goodbye is obviously written about our dads. It was a song that, you know, was very personal to all of us, especially to myself and Keane. About myself and Keane's dad passing away, and obviously about Mark and Shane's dad still being here. So it's quite a weird song to kind of juggle, if you like, lyrically. But we all co-wrote the song together with John, and we think we came up with something beautiful. It's very special to have a song like this on the album, when you've written it yourself and you know exactly where the lyrics came from, and then you're vocaling them yourself. It's a nice touch and a great way to finish the album. And an interesting fact is the guy, Eric Rigler, I think his name is, who played on the Titanic song. Not the Titanic, the ship. Because he would be...
Celine Dion's song, My Heart Will Go On.
My Heart Will Go On, that's the name of Shane.
There it is.
He actually played on this as well, so it's kind of cool. So yeah, that's the album. Thank you very much for joining us, and we'll see you soon.
In my eyes, and I can face the darkest day and fight the tears inside.